Hey guys, it's Dave from PMTVUK, and we're back with Paul Hindmarsh and the Line 6 Helix. We've got quite a fun video for you guys now. We're going to compare the Helix effects with their real-life counterparts. We have the Voodoo Labs Micro Vibe, a TS-808 tube screamer, a script MXR Phase 90, and an MXR Dynacomp, up against the Scream 808, the Red Squeeze, the script mod Phase, and the...
Ubiquitous Vibe
in the Helix. So Paul, if you want to get your play on, and I'll scroll
I've never done this before on camera with these pedals, so this should be interesting.
Exciting for everyone involved.
I have faith. Put me on the spot tonight. So yeah, so I'll just do some playing, and you're going to flick through some different
sounds. Yes, through our lovely little camera here, with some lovely editing magic. We'll see what's what.
Yeah, I'll maybe just explain. I mean, basically what we've got here is I've set up four different effects loops in Helix. Mm-hmm. I've laid it out so they're along the top, and I've actually put the Helix models along the bottom there awesome. As well. So if you just switch in the top one and then switch it off, and we'll listen to the actual Helix model as well. So yeah, let's go through all four of those.
Excellent. And where would you like to start? Loop one or loop four and work back?
Up to you. Up to you. I'm just going to play. I'm going to play some cheesy blues licks and see what.
Blues, then let's start with the tube streamer.
See what happens. Right, okay. So let's hear the sort of. The normal sound first. Well, I'll just stop playing.
Let's work the dry signal first.
Yeah.
That sounded bloody cool. That was good.
I couldn't really tell.
I could not tell at all, mate.
You were switching.
We should do a blind test.
Yeah, so that's a Scream 808 in the Helix and in Ivan's Tube Screamer.
TS-808. Yeah. The original one.
Okay,
let's rock over to the Red Squeeze, the compressor.
Okay, so something a bit... Yeah, okay. So...
Mate, I haven't got to say anything. That's doing all the talking. It's genuinely doing all the talking. Hope you guys can hear it for yourself as well. Insanity.
Okay.
Right.
Next up, effects loop number three.
My personal favourite pedal on the planet.
Okay.
The script phase. I'll tell you what, Paul, that sounds bloody good. That sounds absolutely badass.
It sounds the same and it feels the same to me.
It feels a massive thing, and if it feels the same, that's half the battle, to be fair.
Indeed. Now one of my favourite pedals.
The Univibe.
And I actually have this same Univibe as well.
The Voodoo Labs.
I love this pedal. I've used it for a long time. But I have to admit that since last June, mm-hmm. it hasn't been out of its box, so it'd be interesting to hear them both side by side.
Let's rock it.
Some new thing to play. ¶¶
That is remarkable. That is absolutely remarkable. I mean, the vibe is praised on this for how
it is,
how
yeah,
good of a vibe it is, not how much it was like developed in the development stage.
Absolutely, yeah.
It's a remarkable thing.
And it's kind of backed up what I did all like last year when I first got the Helix, which was it just replaced all the pedals, you know. I mean, I've got some of these classic pedals, and you know, just being able to take out one unit and one
and
box and do that, yeah, and just take that and record with those sounds and everything as well. I mean, there must be like 78 different or more with the updates, different effects in there, you know. So I mean, there's probably quite a lot of money on the floor there.
Oh, without a shadow of a doubt, yeah.
Yeah, quite a bit of money on the floor there, you know. So it's yeah.
I mean, that's what makes Helix so popular. You can have that anywhere you go, recording or live, and have exactly the same sound.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it may be that you may buy a Helix and actually not be interested in the amp models at all. There might be a lot of stuff in the Helix you don't need, you know. But even if it replaces, I don't even want to estimate how much money there is on the floor there. Yeah. But even if you just used 8 different pedals on it that sound killer, and you've got all those different settings and all that different control over things, it would make it worth it just in that as an effects processor, you know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Awesome. Right. Well, putting us on the spot tonight, but
that was fun though. I enjoyed that. I've never seen a video like that before as well.
Think it worked out.
So I'm glad it went well. I hope you enjoyed that. Be sure to give it a like. Sorry again, Paul, for putting you on the spot. Be sure to subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube too. If you want any more details on Helix or any of the pedals we have on the floor, check out PMTonline.co.uk or give us a call at one of our forever expanding PMT stores. Each one of our 15 stores has its own Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook page. Be sure to like your local one, or them all, if you're feeling that nice. I've been Dagan, the lovely Paul Hindmarsh, and we shall see you next time.